April 30th, 2002, San Francisco, California. A university student takes a 45-minute morning drive to start his first day of work in a temp position at 2400 Bayshore Parkway in Mountain View, California, in the Silicon Valley. It was for a little-known company at the time called Google. You've probably heard of it. This was one of their small offices with maybe around 20 employees at the time. They were hiring for a new department called Google AdWords, but they weren't immediately ready to hire full-time just yet. So every day, this temp, which was short for temporary, clocked into work at an uncertain job to review Google ads, along with hundreds of other temps over a three-month period, and watched in horror as dozens of fellow colleagues got let go every single day because, well, they weren't the right fit. It was a scary time.
You're fired.
The moment that changed everything. Google closed the deal of the century. They merged with AOL. You know, American Online.
You've got mail.
Remember that? The bin, as it was called, went from 100 ads to over 100,000 ads. Literally, overnight, Google was overwhelmed. They were finally ready to grow the team. The opportunity to transition full-time had finally arrived after a grueling series of interviews, multiple rounds that went on for weeks, including the final one with Sheryl Sandberg, who was the AdWords director at the time. This temp finally secured a permanent position. That temp was me. When I got my dream job at Google in 2002, I thought I would stay there forever. I mean, why would I ever want to leave? It was everybody's dream job, and for an immigrant like me, it was a dream come true. I moved from Hong Kong to the United States with my father when I was 5 in pursuit of the American dream. We came to the land of opportunity, but that didn't happen right away. We spoke no English, we struggled, we had to scratch and crawl for everything we got, and we're lucky if we had food on the table that day. Sometimes we wouldn't, and if we did, you better believe we earned it. Because of that, to this very day, I still finish all my food, take every last bite, never let anything go to waste, even if I'm full, because I still remember what it was like to go to bed hungry. At school, I was bullied, I faced racism, I endured bigotry. As a foreign minor in a huge unfamiliar pond, I experienced prejudice at a very young age, felt firsthand how cruel the world could really be. Land of opportunity, American dream, reality was far from it. But I didn't give up. In fact, it pushed me to work hard, to study hard. I had to prove everyone wrong, and so I did. I got my honors, won spelling bees, public speaking contests, all kinds of awards. I was the top student in my class. As a writer, speller, presenter, I became a language tutor to help even native speakers to improve their English and Chinese in reading, writing, and speaking.
大家好，你好吗？ Hello, 再见, again. See you next time.
I worked 5 dot-com jobs to get through college at San Jose State University. In the process, I discovered the internet and started making money online. This was all the way back in 1997, when the internet was still a baby. 3 years later, the dot-com bubble suddenly bursted, and my world came crashing down. I lost everything. Dead broke. I continued classes while taking more part-time jobs at my school. Tutor, IT, proofreader, writer, editor, designer, promoter, I did them all. One day, a classified ad in my school newspaper caught my attention. It was a temp job at Google. In 2002, no one had heard of the company, so it was a huge risk. But it sounded like a good deal. Flexible hours, open to students, reasonable wage, fun culture, lots of perks. But here's the kicker. Free meals, unlimited beverages, all the snacks you could eat all day long. I was sold. As a college student living off of soy sauce over rice and 10-cent ramen noodles when they were on sale, or if I really wanted to indulge.
Now at McDonald's, you can get 39-cent cheeseburgers every Sunday and 29-cent hamburgers every Wednesday. Did somebody say McDonald's?
I would have worked for free just for the food. You can bet I took full advantage of all my free breakfasts, lunches, and dinners. I gained 15 pounds in 2 weeks. Not only that, but I also enjoyed company events, holiday parties, team outings, and so much more. I was lucky enough to transition full-time even before graduation, so I definitely worked hard and studied hard. But I was already used to hard work, so it was no problem for me. At Google, I started the optimization team, created the agency team, developed top-level strategies, training, and tools, many of which still being used today. I was the top guy. It was the best time of my life, and I am forever grateful for my time there. For years, I helped my clients make more money as Google's most senior optimizer, agency partner, and customer representative. I've seen the potential. My clients were making millions, and so I knew I had to do something. April 30th, 2004, 2 years to the day after my first day as a temp at Google, I launched my blog, wrote my first blog post, created history. I knew copywriting, marketing, content training. After all, I did all of that for a living at the world's number one tech company, so I knew I had the skills. I just needed to figure out how to turn that talent into online income as an entrepreneur in my own business. Then I found it, the opportunity of a lifetime. This was my chance. The Internet Success Mentoring Club, which was the advanced mentorship program from IMC, the Internet Marketing Center, to learn from the founder and CEO, Corey Rudel, the only man at the time who had broken the seven-figure code online. In fact, eight figures, over $40 million. And that year alone, 2005, he had already made over $7 million. There was absolutely no one better to learn from. So I applied to work with them, and I waited and I waited. One of many days later, I was at work, as I always was. At Google, we had moved to Building 44 at 1625 Charleston Road, right across the street from the new Google headquarters at the now famous address, 1600 Amphitheater Parkway. My phone went off. It was from Corey Rudel. I was thrilled, like you wouldn't believe. I dropped everything and quickly ran outside to take the call, right here at this very spot. It was outstanding news. His team actually accepted my application into their mentorship program for $8,000. Yes, it was a lot. My life savings at the time. But I didn't even think twice. I took it. I was so excited. This was it. It had to be, and it was at the time. In fact, I got my results relatively quickly because I took massive action. Made my first affiliate sale on my very own website. Proved that making money online was possible for me once again, and in a much more permanent way. A method that still works to this very day. Then came the surprise, the anticipation. The Canadian Corey Rudel at last had planned a trip out to California to pursue his passion for racing at the California Speedway. After that, his next stop would be the Silicon Valley. Where I lived, the appointment was set. I was going to meet him, be able to thank him in person, face to face, man to man. But before I got the chance to shake his hand in gratitude, this happened.
Two people killed when a high-performance sports car crashes at the California Speedway in Fontana.
And then around 11 o'clock this morning, a driver and a passenger in this Porsche Carrera GT simply lost control and hit a wall on the straightaway. One person died at the scene. A second individual was airlifted to a local hospital, but later died.
June 2nd, 2005, Fontana, California, at the California Speedway. It wasn't meant to be. In the blink of an eye, I lost my mentor. I lost my investment. I lost all my momentum. It turned out not to be the opportunity of a lifetime that I was expecting. But you know what? It was a stepping stone. My stepping stone. That's why I didn't let it stop me. I started over. I launched my company. I built my website, my blog, my sales pages. I was still going to do it, to make it. I had to, no matter what. For me, for my family, for Corey. April 30th, 2006, 4 years after my first day at Google, 2 years after my first blog post, I got invited to attend my very first internet marketing seminar happening the following week. And May 4th, I was in San Antonio, Texas. I was in the presence of some of the top internet marketers at the time, a room full of leaders, experts, millionaires, including the man who would later be my inspiration to resign from Google and become a full-time internet entrepreneur.
I'm Mike Filsaid.
Mike was the guy in internet marketing. He launched his product online and on day one made over $500,000. Just 4 days later, $1 million. He was the first and only active expert I bought an online course from at the time called Carbon Copy Marketing. It was so good, I also bought his second product called Butterfly Marketing. It did not disappoint. Mike was the real deal. I knew I needed to meet him.
He saw me in San Antonio and he said, Mike, I'm very glad to meet you. I know you quit working on August 5th of 2004. I'm going to quit working for Google on August 5th of 2006. I said, wow, that's good. And, you know, he's just a real big success in the industry now.
August 5th, 2006, my last day as a Googler. This was the day. I've always been the man of my word, but this time, there was actually somebody to keep me accountable. I was right here in this parking lot, in yet another Google building, when my phone rang. It was Mike. I took the call as I entered the Googleplex as an employee for the very last time.
Hello.
Hey, Mike. It's Simon.
Yeah, hey, what's up? What's up, buddy? What's going on?
Listen, I'm right outside my boss's office at Google. I'm about to go give my notice. What?
Simon, are you sure? You've got a job at Google, dude.
No.
Like, I feel guilty that I've given him this day. He goes, no. I've never felt more right about this thing. I'm going to go and quit. I just wanted to
say thank you very much for the inspiration. I said,
well, dude, don't leave me hanging, man. Call me back when it's done. And then he went in and he said he was done. And then, you know, Simon went on to do some legendary things in the internet business.
From that day forward, August 5th would forever be known to us as Freedom Day. My life had changed forever. The rest, as they say, is history. I became the entrepreneur I'm known to be today. My first launch made over $100,000 in 7 days. My business earned over $500,000 before my first year was over. Crossed the seven-figure mark shortly into year two. Started speaking at seminars all over the country and subsequently across the world's platforms. Shared stages with the best in the industry. Won multiple best speaker awards. Published multiple bestsellers. Built my own event company, agency service, and online community of success stories, all guaranteed to achieve instantaneous results. On Google, on YouTube, for anything they want to promote, for free.
Hi, this is Michael Singh. Simon can teach you more things about driving traffic and converting traffic and making sure that your sites are perfect for the terms of service for all of the search engines, especially Google. Man, I got to tell you, the guy has connections. He's gotten me into the Googleplex, and I've had some pretty interesting conversations with some Google and YouTube employees, and I even got a free lunch out of it. So, as you know, the game is always changing, and one of the guys that's cutting edge that always gives me up-to-date information, there's one guy that I turn to, and that's Simon Lee Youngs.
Fast forward to 2020.
Today, the World Health Organization officially announced that this is a global pandemic.
The global pandemic, quarantine, catastrophe, businesses shut down, offices closed down, the entire world on lockdown.
Malaysian Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin has announced a nationwide lockdown.
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 Psy is a very, very good friend, and he's going to be working with us to do a couple of things that are pretty exciting.
Whether you let this make you or break you, it's your choice to make. For me, I took the chance to turn crisis into opportunity. 15 years after first learning from Mike online, meeting him in person, and subsequently changing my life through his inspiration, we have finally transformed our friendship into partnership. And it came to us at the perfect time. Mike has created a tremendous platform for entrepreneurs, business owners, and internet marketers. Everything you need to start and run your digital business. Website funnel builder, email autoresponder, e-commerce platform, online sales system, affiliate software, membership sites, live and automated webinars, and more. But it's not just tools. You also get education, community access, business opportunity, all for free. So, where do I come in? Well, for the first time ever, I am offering exclusive online mentorship, also for free. I'm adding on to everything Mike already has with my own mastermind group that directly complements Mike's platform. Here, I will show you how to make money online, lifetime revenue, residual commissions, passive income, and get this, without selling anything, just by giving away top quality products for free. More specifically, Mike's robust software tools, which you can also access for free. Yes, this means that you get to work with both Mike and me. I can't begin to tell you how excited we are to share this opportunity with you, because I'll tell you what, Freedom Day has been our thing since 2006. But now, together, we will be creating more Freedom Days for new aspiring entrepreneurs, the next generation of internet marketers, success stories of the future. And for being here right now, it could very well be you. Intrigued? Don't miss your chance to access your free membership from both Mike and myself. Free at no cost to you, but only for a limited time. So if you want in, take massive action to sign up immediately for your free lifetime membership to work with us both right now. And together, let's help you to create your own Freedom Day.
August 5th, 2006. To me, it was a date. To him, it was an inspiration.